Searching for suitable topics, I always received a lot of information about the organization, lack of communication or cooperation, deficient interfaces, unreliable suppliers, and a desire to reduce costs. But that didn't really help me, and it is difficult to filter suitable topics out of this information. That's why I turned the tables at one point. I'll ask the questions, politely, of course. Please keep in mind that a belt often has the role of a consultant, who depends on the trust and cooperation of colleagues, especially in projects outside the usual working environment. Six Sigma projects start with a problem, and problems are attached to outputs. Outputs are real or virtual objects. They can always be indicated by just a noun or a compound noun, like shopping list, ingredient, dough sheet, and cookie. Outputs are countable as they result from a repetitive process. In a flow production with continuous output, the product can be a container. In the service sector, contracts, invoices, data entries, answers, decisions, deliveries, and even patients are countable outputs. If you complete the sentence, "the output is," then you define the object itself. For example, cookie is a foodstuff. If you complete the sentence, "the output has," then you describe its attributes. For example, cookie has a taste, weight, calories, and storage location. Neither a cookie or a shopping list itself can be a problem, nor other products and services. These outputs, however, can have problems if their attributes deviate from requirements. Just imagine that all outputs carry a label with all their characteristic attributes, like a label on food packages, but more detailed, which indicate, for example, ingredients, date of manufacture, expiry date, weight, size, color, baking time, oven temperature, consumed energy, working hours required, and so on. Every product and every service could have such a label with all its attributes. What attributes would appear on the imaginary label of one of your outputs? This is not always as easy as with cookies. But it is important and useful to think in terms of attributes. Outputs cannot be measured, but their attributes can. You'll remember that a problem is defined by the deviation of an output in an important attribute, and more specific, a problem is the difference between the required state of the attribute and the actual state of the attribute. If this difference exceeds a generally accepted or even specified limit, then the output has a problem. Do you know of problems that outputs have in your work environment? Every problem can be formulated within the following framework. Output has an attribute which deviates from requirements. For example, cookie taste too salty, cookie delivery too late, or cookie dough consumption too high. Please try to express each of your identified problems in this format. What is the effect? Effects are the consequences of the problem on the company and on the customer. Typical effects on the company are costs and lost revenues. They determine the business case and need to be specified as voice of business. Typical effects of the problems on the customer are dissatisfaction and complaints. They will be specified as voice of customer in our project. What is the cause? Walter Schuert discovered that variations in the process lead to variations in the output. Thus, we must uncover the relationship between the problem and its root cause. But how can we be sure to detect these root causes? The incident analysis offers a suitable procedure for this purpose. Each problem must be triggered by a last negative influence in a chronological causal chain. To find the root causes, we must analyze the entire causal chain from the trigger that releases the problem to an underlying root cause that we can control. Thus, it must always be clear for you, even if you are not a subject matter expert, whether and how it can be that a supposed trigger, like a rotten egg from the input, releases the problem, for example, cookie taste too salty. We will later come back to this topic and analyze the causal chain from the trigger to its root causes with logical, rational, and statistical tools. What is the solution? Solutions eliminate, adjust, or circumvent the identified root causes to switch off the problem. Thus, root causes are the anchors for solutions. Now the problem-solving approach within the process model becomes apparent again. The solution affects the root cause, the root cause and intermediate causes trigger the problem, and the problem has an effect. Our entire daily routine can be divided into inputs, activities, outputs, and problem-solving, even if we are not always aware of it. We start and finish the day with a problem, teeth, plaque layer, to thick. You know the effect of this problem and its solution. You know the necessary input, your activity, the resources, and the method for this service process. You probably also know the best practice method for toothbrushing to achieve teeth, plaque layer, acceptable.